Hey everyone, Skorch82 here with the results of the Sleeping Dogs contest entries. I want to thank everyone who participated in this by sending a video, and even those who weren't able to participate but at least tried to show their support by leaving me a constructive comment or some suggestions for things to do in the future. I'm hoping that based on the activity that I got from this and the response that I got from everybody that I kind of want to try to make this a regular thing. So I'll be looking for some ideas and feedback as we go forward in the future, but more on that soon. So I was able to get about 15 entries. I got about 15 entries to the contest, which I was actually pretty impressed with. This particular method of entry is one that I don't think a lot of people were actually able to pull off, and I must admit that I probably was assuming people would be more comfortable doing something like this more readily than probably they actually are. So part of that could be my fault, and I apologize if I assumed anybody would be more than able to participate. But I've got about 15 entries, and I was able to watch them all, and I wrote down some comments for each one, and then kind of went through and ranked them based on what the person had to say and how I liked the way they delivered their story about what video games meant to them. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to list off the top three, and I'm going to go from third place, second place, first place, you know, obviously, showing off who won. And then I'm going to go through, since I've got a few entries here, not too many that I couldn't, read some comments that I had to say about each person's video. So what I'm going to go through is each person that was in the contest as a runner-up. I'm going to go ahead and read some things that I wrote down about your video. That way I can kind of keep the personal touch on the contest and to extend my thanks for sending in an entry when most people weren't able to. So without further ado, here's number three. So the third place entry came from a user by the name of GameCubes. And I want to start off real fast by saying if I butcher anybody's username, my apologies. Yes, the user GameCube submitted a video that detailed how he got into video gaming a little bit later in life. And the comments that I wrote here are that being a late bloomer doesn't mean it's too late, because it's never too late to get into video games. I personally liked how you related your experience with what you thought was a fairly new game compared to many others, and that was what made it special for you. That was a pretty original spin on the question, and I appreciate the video response to that. Second place was Beastful Gamer. So the things I had to say about this video was, I like the way you related your life to the characters in the video games you play. It's tough to grow up with stresses and things like violence, and I really liked how you were able to relate such a personal story to video games and could attribute that to being able to stay out of trouble. Your descriptions and your speech were very clear. And by the way, nice hat. All right. And that brings me to the winner of the copy of Sleeping Dogs goes to the user Toa of Pi. So this was actually an entry that I got that I was pretty surprised more people didn't really touch on. He covered the aspect of video game music as to what made things memorable for him. And I would have to agree with that, as the video game music tends to be something that I think a lot of people, they take pleasure in remembering that kind of thing, and a lot of people don't even realize that that's the case. So what I had to say about this video was, this was a topic that I actually had thought more people would have touched on, but really nobody did. The music is definitely one of the most memorable aspects of video games, and has a lot of nostalgic and sentimental value to the people that play, even if they don't realize it. I, for one, have some of my fondest memories of games just for the music. Your story was very creative, and I'm pleased to see that you want to turn that interest into a career. You really have some talent. So I want to extend my congratulations to Toa of Pi. I'll be contacting you via private message to determine how to distribute the contest winnings. And I really want to thank everyone who submitted a video. And with that, I'm going to go ahead and just read down my list here. The rest of the entries that I got, just kind of give off some comments. So the next user would be the Wonder Junior. The gameplay was placed well. The volume did not overshadow your speech, though you did seem to stumble on some of your words, and I couldn't tell if it was live or not. But overall, I liked what you had to say. I was the older brother in my family who had a thing for video games, and though my younger brother didn't really take to it like you did, it's cool to see how you guys bond even being 6 years apart. Next user, Flare Blitz 007. Overall, a very good story. The build up in the beginning was pretty clever, and personally, not being a Minecraft fan, I couldn't really relate to the game footage that you showed, but it was a really nice way to put a spin on what you had to say. It was a very good way to add character to the story you had to tell. Next user, MCG Full Volume. So this was a pretty creative video overall, and this one was actually one of those ones that I had trouble deciding between this and some of the ones that made it into the top count. I really liked how you used the game clips to relate to the games that you had growing up as a kid. It really helped to kind of give some visual to your story. As you mentioned, it was a bit hard to hear you. The subtitles were a nice touch, so thanks for doing that. Some of the overlaying was a bit busy on your video, but you've definitely got some talent if you're willing to hone your skills. So, if that's something that you're interested in, I strongly suggest that you keep at it because you've really got something, some potential there. Next user, SuperPwner17. Your entry wasn't all that bad. It was genuine, it was easy to hear, and it made sense. If anybody's wondering, the video description for that particular video called out that the entry was pretty horrible. And I tried to keep from taking what other people had described in the video as how I rated. So I wanted to, you know, at least let you know that your video wasn't as bad as you think. I can definitely relate to your story. It's all about the connection with those people around you and forming memories. I like how you related gaming into shaping who you are, who you've become, and not just who you remember. Next user, Random Encounter 1. Overall, it was a very good story, and I'm glad you did it just to show the support. It's nice to have someone who's tried their hand at this type of hobby to participate in such a way, so thanks for that. Next user, the Shuichi X, I believe. Your story was an original spin on the question, actually. You launched in a discussion about how specific aspects of a particular game influenced and what they meant to you, so I kind of like what you did there. The video was a little longer than I had asked for, but I like what you did with it anyway, so thanks for the entry. Next user, FredZKurz9. The gameplay in your video was a little bit distracting, but I like how you incorporated it into the story that you told. The timeline is always a good place to start, and I like hearing about how people get into gaming. Next user, Death Magnetic. So the mask that you added to that video was pretty funny, but it made it quite hard to understand you. The background music was a little too loud, and it sort of overshadowed some of the things you said, but other than that, I can really relate to games and consoles of that era as well. That always hits home as a personal touch to me, because that's pretty much my story, so it's always nice to meet someone who can appreciate that nostalgia. Next user, Battle Chicken 2. I couldn't tell if some of the background activity was supposed to be part of the video or not. It made it somewhat hard to hear what was actually being discussed, but I like how you took your friends' opinions on the games and turned it into a discussion. I think if I had allowed more time for the video, that something like that could have had more potential. The graphics in the video were a little distracting, and I think the video could have actually done without them, but overall it was a good solid idea. Next user, SquiddishLuck19. The background noise in your video was a little distracting. I couldn't tell if maybe it was a TV or something running in the background, so it was kind of hard to pay attention to what you were saying, but your story about how games help you deal with things in life is pretty good. I mean, it wasn't totally original, given all the other entries that I saw, but every entry is personal, so it's really hard to rate on what somebody's experiences are. So I can definitely appreciate anything that somebody's got to say about video games shaping them personally. Many people tend to get into video games to do that kind of thing rather than simply for casual fun, so I appreciate your ability to talk about things like that. Next user, Secret Spartan. Your story was pretty original given the parameters of the contest. I like how you related how you can get into each type of game depending on the genre. Your reference to learning to read from games is actually pretty impressive, since it's not what most people would actually attribute being able to read to. It was very hard to hear you, but I got what you were saying, so thanks for the entry. The last entry actually is one that was not posted as a video response, and I know I said that was one of the requirements for the contest, but since this user, I think, was unable to post the video in said method because of the device used to do it, I just wanted to call it out as an honorable mention. I say thanks for your entry. I'm glad you were able to submit it, even though it looks like you're unable to fully participate due to restrictions on whatever device you used to capture the video. Your story was very real and something we can all relate to, and I can definitely attest to having some of the same thoughts you did about the games I used to play as well. So that was the announcements for all of the results for the video. I want to extend again my thanks to everybody that participated. This overall was a pretty good idea, and I got a lot of constructive feedback. And I want to thank everybody again for, taking the time to do this, because it was really, hopefully it was not only an eye-opening experience for me, but for anyone who participated as well. Maybe you can turn this into a hobby. So once again, congratulations to Toa of Pi. And thank the rest of you again for your participation. And once again, I hope you continue watching. I'll see you all later.